are you deploying this to AWS? And if the answer is yes, then all of the go. So basically the access key ID as well as the secret ID. What's going on, guys? Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to Amigoscode. In this video, I want to walk you through this pull request review by one of my students. I've seen a few things which I felt maybe it's worth for you to know, because the goal with this series is for you to learn how to write better code. Now, if you're new to my channel, literally just take 1 second, subscribe. Also, if you enjoy these kind of videos, smash the like button so I can keep on bringing you these type of contents, because it's all about giving you with the best advice and also discuss with you guys, right? So I've been learning from you guys and also you've been learning. So sometimes there are things that I say and people say, oh, you could do this way or another way, which is really good for all of us to benefit. The other thing that I want to say is currently the program, so this is part of the Amigoscode mentorship program, where we go through 10 weeks as a group and we build software together. So currently it's basically fully booked, so we are running the second cohort, but as soon as the third cohort opens up, I will let you know. So we are finding a way of scaling things. Maybe we should have 2-3 cohorts running at the same time, but at the moment I will let you know very soon. So the pull request that I have here is by, I'm not even gonna mention his name, so
why
I don't want him to think that I'm picking on him, but instead I'm just giving you feedback so that you can improve yourself as an engineer. So this pull request here has 18 changes, and the goal of this pull request here, it's media saving in here, so the title is called media saving. So maybe here it's not really media saving, but it's more like files, or saving files to S3 or S3 file integration. So work on the naming for your titles. Okay, now let's navigate and start from the top here. So here we have the pom.xml, so these are the dependencies. So here you have AWS Java SDK version 1. whatever. And right now I can tell you that this is wrong. Okay, so here, so they have the version 2. So version 1 actually is deprecated and you should migrate to version 2. So use v2 in here. So I'm just going to start the review. There we go. And also, I don't think that this is needed. So Spring Cloud Starter AWS. So maybe not needed. But I'll see in your code whether you actually use this. Okay, so let's move on. So here we kind of have the controllers, and right, so here image controller. So I'm not gonna go deep into the API stuff which we've done before, but here, so we should say final. And one cool thing actually here is that we can basically add a suggestion. So here I'm gonna say private final, and then add review, and then you could just accept it. So you can see here, right? And then the same for this guy right here. So this should be private and then final, just like that. And we have the post mapping in here. So this is post mapping customer ID upload. And we take the customer ID plus the image. And this right here is actually incorrect. So don't throw. So here, basically what you're doing is you're letting the framework decide on how to handle the exception, right? So you want to upload an image, but this is an IO exception. So surely that you are sending the image. Yeah, so this is incorrect, okay? Also, so here, remember the entire architecture. So don't do this, okay? So don't do this. Don't get the customer and then upload in here. So all of this should be part of the service class, okay? Move this logic to service class. And I'm not going to spend, you know, 30 minutes on this pull request, but instead I'm just going to give you the main points, okay? So that's it. So basically upload a file for a customer. And then here, when you get the image, you say media ID, right? So I think you're mixing few things. So you're saying image and media. So just stick with one, okay? So here we have get image, and the response entity is an S3 object. So that this is wrong, okay? So get image. So this should actually return a byte array, the image itself. Now, if you look into the S3 object will contain a bunch of stuff. Let me show you. So in here, you can see that this is the class S3 object. And have a look. So the method summary, close, get bucket name, get key, get object content. So this is exactly what you want, right? So you are basically sending a bunch of stuff to the client, which it's not necessarily needed, okay? So this is actually wrong. So this should be the byte array, and then you can get the actual contents from it, okay? So let's scroll down in here. So same thing here. So this will be final, and then S3 client, and then the bucket name from the environment variables. So I think this is also wrong, because your service class now can only work upon one bucket, right? So instead, you should change this so that it's more flexible, right? So you should be able to pass a bucket that you are working with, right? And also maybe extract this right here into its own class so that other service classes can use it. Because right now it's so specific to one bucket, okay? So this needs some work. Then basically here, upload image. So we generate the key. Then we save to S3. And basically, if there is an exception, you throw back, right? So you throw an IO exception, which is fine. So I think you're doing this because of save to image, or actually save to S3. So this guy right here, so this, I think S3 client put object, so this throws an exception, right? So you better basically handle the exception right here, and then depending on the response status that you get back from the API call, you can translate that into your own exception, okay? So never throw this right here. So this is wrong, okay? So here you save, and then you create the media, and you set the UID, the type, and the customer in here. Okay, cool. So, and then you save, just like that. And in here, you are getting a few things from the image. So the size, the content type, and right, so if you are saving images, so maybe basically, so from the content type from the image, then check if it's an image, right? So check whether this is an image. And if it's not an image, then don't store, right? And then you can basically throw an exception, say, hey, invalid content type, for example, okay? Cool, so then you have, so I'm not gonna leave the comments here because it's just gonna drag this video. Then you have get image in here. So you pass the UID. So you get the media, and then or else throw illegal argument exception. So this, I think it will resemble a 500. So you need to be careful, and maybe like say resource not found, and then have a custom status code sent to the client. And then you basically say S3 and then get, right? But here again, you're throwing, right? So it might not exist in your database, but also what about if it doesn't exist within S3? Okay. What about if it doesn't exist within S3? So you have to handle this scenario as well. Okay. So try and catch in here. And then depending on the status code that you get back from the API call that you perform with S3 client, then you provide the right status code back to the client. Cool. So again, this is probably not needed because you should refactor this so that it works against multiple buckets and not just one specific bucket. All right, cool. So then S3 config. Now, the problem with this in here, I've got one question to you, right? Are you deploying this to AWS? And if the answer is yes, then all of so basically the access key ID as well as the secret ID, right? because you can use iamb roles to basically check whether the instance, so the AWS or EC2 instance, has the correct permissions to interact with your bucket. And also, so here, basic AWS credentials. So this is not needed, okay? If you are deploying to AWS, because you can get the credentials from the instance profile, okay? So this can go, and this also can go if you're not deploying within AWS. Now, if you are deploying outside AWS, this is when you need this. But even though, if you're deploying outside AWS, then I would suggest you to use the content store provided by the cloud provider instead of basically from, let's say, Google Cloud trying to store to AWS, which doesn't really make sense. And I'm pretty sure that you are deploying this to AWS, or you are going to deploy this to AWS. So this can go, okay? And let me quickly show you on the docs. So in here, I've got the AWS SDK for Java, and you can see that basically version 1, and then there's version 2, and there's a migration guide. Okay, so migrate your code to version 2. So if we go into the developer guide in here, we should see a section on, I think it's use the SDK, provide temporary credentials. And in here, you can see that they have something called the default credentials provider chain. And have a look. So in here, so they have the order, okay? So this is the order, Java, system properties, environment variables, which is the one that you are using. And then you have web identity, yada, yada. And then the one that I was saying to you is in here. So Amazon EC2 instance role. Basically, right? So the SDK uses the instance profile credentials provider to load temporary credentials from the Amazon EC2 metadata service, okay? So basically, it tries all of these, and basically, I think, yeah, so you are using this, which I don't recommend, okay? Because these are secrets, and you don't want to, you know, have secrets laying around, because if anyone steals the secrets, then off you go. Okay, cool. So hopefully you've learned something new here. Then let me just scroll down. And in here, I can see that you have this generic controller. So, right. So generic controller. I'm not really sure why. I've seen people have an abstract class with a generic controller. I'm not entirely sure if you need this, right? So the simpler the code, the better, okay? Because here, I think all you're doing is you're passing the data, message, status code, and then you're passing the timestamp. And I think that's pretty much it, right? So I don't think this is adding any value in here. Let me just scroll down and see. So here, a couple of changes. So this is a part of the refactor that you're doing, I think. And then you have the media in here, the type, blah, blah, blah. You have the media repository. All right, so I think we'll leave it. Oh, what is this? Right, so we spoke about this in here. So AWS S3, and then probably this would be file uploads bucket, for example, right? Not just bucket, because you could have multiple buckets within AWS S3 or within S3. and then string regex. I haven't seen this, but this is, yeah, I don't know what it, this is like an email validator. So have better names, okay? So email validation regex, something like that. I'm not really sure what is that. And then you have tests. So image controller tests. So here you're testing the controller. And one thing which I can see, which is wrong, is that you are mocking. So controllers, you should never mock within controllers, okay? So there's ways that you can actually test by mocking the S3 implementation, right? And because you basically haven't abstracted things well enough, it's impossible for you to do it right now, okay? And yeah, so right, so this is all wrong. And then this is the service, which in here, cool, so that's fine, using mocks. That's absolutely fine. And that's it. Cool. So hopefully you've learned something new, and I'll leave a link for the video where I show you how to implement this the right way. Go and check it out. And if you enjoyed this video, thumbs up. Also, if you're new to the channel, subscribe, and let me know what other videos you want to see next. This is all for now. Catch me on the next one. Assalamu alaikum.